nice to see so many people. Thank you all for coming. That's brilliant.
I won't be doing the juggling this time. And we're not allowed to use live tigers anymore, so I'm afraid some of the things we had the last time. I always think this is a Colin Sands song, and I always think this is a very nice one to start off any evening. Rest for a while, now the night is young. The time is short and the road is long. Tell me a story, I'll sing you a song. For tomorrow the road will be calling us on. Don't let your journey be stopped at the start. There are times when your feet have to follow your heart. But the faster you travel, the less you can see. And the more that you have, the less you can be. Rest for a while, now the night is young. The time is short and the road is long. Tell me a story, I'll sing you a song. For tomorrow the road will be calling us on. Smile at the door, where we sat round the table and danced on the floor. Felt warmth in the fire and came back for more. There was grass on the chimney and the lock on the door. Rest for a while, now the night is young. The time is short and the road is long. Tell me a story, I'll sing you a song. For tomorrow the road will be calling us on. So let the reel have its turn and the song its refrain. And here's to the day when we all meet again. And long may the sun shine wherever you are. But you still need the darkness to show you the stars. Rest for a while, now the night is young. The time is short and the road is long. Tell me a story, I'll sing you a song. For tomorrow the road will be calling us on. Rest for a while. Time is short and the road is long. Tell me a story, I'll sing you a song. For tomorrow the road will be calling us on. Yes, tomorrow the road will be calling us on.
To do tonight is about songs that tell stories and stories that tell stories. So I'm going to carry on with one by Richard Thompson, which I think tells a very evocative sort of story. I was 19 when I came to town. They called it the summer of love. They were burning babies, burning flags, the hawks against the doves. I took a job in the steamy down on Cauldron Street, and I fell in love with the laundry girl who was working next to me. Oh, she was a rare thing, fine as a bee's wing, so fine a breath of wind might blow her away. Oh, she was a lost child, she was running wild. She said, as long as there's no price on love, I'll stay. And you wouldn't want me any
zigzagged across her face, her look of half surprise. Like a fox caught in the headlights, there was animal in her eyes. She said, young man, oh, can't you see, I'm not the factory kind. If you don't take me out of here, well, I'll surely lose my mind. Oh, she was a rare thing, fine as a bee's wing, so fine that I might crush her where she lay. Lost child, she was running wild. She said, as long as there's no price on love, I'll stay. And you wouldn't want me any other way. We busked around the market towns and picked fruit down in Kent. And we could tinker pots and pans and knives wherever we went. And I said that we might settle down, get a few acres dug, a fire burning in the hearth and babies on the rug. She said, oh man, you foolish man, it surely sounds like hell. You might be lord of half the world, but you'll not own me as well. Oh, she was a rare thing, fine as a bee's wing, so fine a breath of wind might blow her away. Oh, she was a lost child, she was running wild. She said, as long as there's no price on love, I'll stay. And you wouldn't want me any other way. We were camping down in the gallow one time. The work was pretty good. She thought we shouldn't stay for the frosts, I thought maybe we should. We were drinking more in those times, and tempers reached a pitch. And like a fool I let her go with that rambling itch. The last I heard she was sleeping rough, back on the Derby beat. White horse in her pocket and a wolfhound at her feet. And they say that she even married once a man named Romany Brown, but even a gypsy caravan was too much settling down. And they say her flower is faded now, harsh weather and hard booze. Well, maybe that's just the price you pay for the chains that you refuse. Oh, she was a rare thing, fine as a bee's wing, and I miss her more than ever words can say. If I could just taste all the wildness now, if I could hold her in my arms today, well, I wouldn't want it any other way.
To know, if you've not heard this song before, is that blue bonnets are a kind of lupin that grows on the, around the Gulf of Mexico. Gulf Coast Highway, he worked. He worked the rice fields with their coal dark wells. He worked the oil fields in the Gulf of Mexico. The only thing we've ever owned is this old house here by the road. And when he dies, he says he'll catch some blackbird's wing and he will fly away to heaven come some sweet blue bonnet. born in spring. She walked through springtime when I was home. Our days were sweet, our nights were warm. The seasons changed, the jobs would come, the flowers fade, and this old house felt so alone when the world took me away. And when she dies, she says she'll catch some blackbird's wing and she will fly away to heaven come some sweet blue morning spring. Highway 19, the jobs are gone. We tend our garden, we set the sun. This is the only place on earth where the bonnets grow. And once a year they come and go. But this old house here by the road. And when we die, we say we'll catch some blackbird's wing and we will fly away. To heaven come some sweet blue morning spring. Yes, when we die, we say we'll catch some blackbird's wing and we will fly away. To heaven come some sweet blue morning spring.
So I'll go off on, but couldn't make it here this evening. But we will do our best. I'll ask Robbie to join me. Where would you like to hear that one? Whenever I hear Scarborough Fair suck, because we're so used, I think, to hearing the Simon and Garfunkel version of it with canticles sung over it. But whenever I hear Scarborough Fair, I might just grab a drink of water on the table. I always think there's something missing. So Robbie and I, without the aid of a safety net, will attempt to try Scarborough Fair and Canticle. And Robbie's agreed to play on this occasion.
Fight for the cause, they long ago forgot.
I'm really looking forward to hearing what that sounds like, hopefully. The next thing I'm going to do, as some of you probably realise, I write stories and have published a few books, and one of the sequences that I've done have been short comedy stories of about 500 words or so. The books are on the back, they're not actually for sale, but if you did feel moved to want one, you just put my pen name into Amazon, which is Swan Morrison. It's not my real name. But I thought I'd read you one of the stories. Most of the stories that I write come from things that have occurred to me as I've just in everyday life. And we have open gardens in your village. We have open gardens in our village. And it occurred to me one day what would happen if somebody tried to slip in quickly to open their garden, to sort of fit it in with the others, to make a few bob. And this was the premise of this story called The Open Garden. George sat in the deck chair at his garden gate. He was about to count the money in his collecting tin when a male voice interrupted. "Excuse me, is this one of the open gardens?" "Yes," replied George, glancing up at a middle-aged couple. "Only you're not on the map of open gardens they gave us in the village." "No," George agreed. "I was a late entry and there wasn't time to add me to any paperwork. It's just £1 each to look round," he continued, lifting his tin. His visitor contributed their admission fees, and George directed them to the rear of the bungalow. He looked up and down the lane and saw no sign of other visitors. It was late in the afternoon, and it was likely these would be the last. George painfully rose and limped to join his guests. "It's rather different from the other gardens we've seen today," ventured his male visitor as George reached the couple. "There aren't any plants," noted the woman. "The old arthritis stopped me from doing too much gardening these days," George explained. "So I went for a simple low-maintenance theme of just grass and S-P-I-S.
S-P-I-S,
queried the woman. "Self-planting indigenous species."
"You mean weeds?"
"Weed is just a name for a plant growing in the wrong place," replied George. "My SPIS all carefully harmonised to construct a natural uncultivated effect."
"And the grass is 3 feet tall," observed the man.
"I like to think that it forms a counterpoint juxtaposed to the manicured greenery characteristic of the other exhibited gardens." The three looked out across the rusting mattress springs and other discarded household equipment to the fire-gutted shell of an old motor car beyond. "I'm particularly pleased with that modern art installation," announced George with pride. "I may enter it for the Turner Prize." Before the couple could comment, the grass on the far side of the garden began to ripple, tracing the path of some hidden approaching creature. The sound of growls and snarls reached their ears.
"Oh, that's Rufus, my Rottweiler," said George. "I don't know what's going into him today. He's bitten four of the visitors and won't be taken away by ambulance."
George looked round to see his guests fleeing, panic-stricken, from the garden.
"They're serving tea and cakes in the village hall," George helpfully shouted after them before his voice was drowned out by the savage barking of Rufus.
George sat down in his deck chair, and Rufus, having seen off the intruders, lay quietly down on the ground beside him.
"Let's count the day's takings, boy," George said to his companion. "I reckon we've got over 60 quid here. That'll pay for getting all that rubbish taken away from the back garden."
He patted Rufus on the head. "With any luck, there'll be enough money left to have the grass cut and to get you a nice bun." If you like that, the books, there's three books each containing 100 similar stories, so there's 299 where that came from. I'm going to tell another sort of story now, which is, how are we doing for time? We're doing quite well for time, aren't we, really? I'm going to tell another story now, which is quite a lot of the songs I pick up, as you probably realise, are from things that people sing here and on such. The other great source of stuff I've never heard of is the Sobers and Strummers, a ukulele band that I play with. This is a song that I hadn't heard before. It's from the 1980s by a German group called Nana, I think they're pronounced.
and it's an anti-war song, which I don't normally do. It's quite an interesting song, and it's kind of reminded me of something I saw in the newspaper where allegedly, I don't know if this is apocryphal, it was written as if it was true and I had the name of the person, that this Russian who was monitoring the potential attacks by America saw something on the radar screens that looked for all the world like incoming American ballistic missiles. But he paused telling the Kremlin for 10 minutes just to double check, and it turned out to be a mistake. And the way the story developed was that possibly he had told the Kremlin earlier there could have been an accidental nuclear war starting. So this is of a similar ilk. You and I in a little toy shop, buy a bag of balloons with the money we've got, set them free at the break of dawn, till one by one they are gone. Back at base, bugs in the software, send the message, something's out there floating in the summer sky. 99 red balloons go by. Floating in a summer sky. Panic bells, it's red alert, there's something here from somewhere else. The war machine springs into life, opens up one eagle eye, focusing it on the sky. There's 99 red balloons go by. Ninety-nine Decision Street, 99 ministers meet. Worry, worry, super scurry, call the troops out in a hurry. This is what we've waited for, this is it boys, this is war. The president is on the line. There's 99 red balloons go by. 99 nights off the air, ride super high-tech jet fighters, everyone a superhero, everyone a Captain Kirk, with orders to identify, to classify and clarify, scramble in the summer sky. There's 99 red balloons go by. 99 dreams I have had, and everyone a red balloon. It's over now and I'm standing pretty in this dust that was a city. If I could find a souvenir just to prove the world was here, and here it is, a red balloon, I think of you and let it go. Two have us handy. This should be a standing up. I used to talk about standing up and sitting down songs, don't I? This should be a standing up song, but the version I learned was Noel Gallagher sitting down on the stage, and I'm not sure he's got plans to do a standing up version. So. I would like to leave this city, this old town don't smell too pretty yet. I can feel the warning signs running around my mind. When I leave this island, I'll put myself into a soul inside a man. I can feel the warning signs running around my mind. Scratching around in the same old hole. My body feels young, but my mind is very
stay, but I just can't stand it. And I feel the warning signs running around my mind. When I leave this spirit, I'll find me a hole and I'll live in it. And I can feel the warning signs running around my mind. Here I go, scratching around in the same old hole. My body feels young, but my mind is very old. What do you say? You can't give me the dreams of the mind anyway. You have the world away. Have the world away. You have the world away. I am lost.
Circulating around various open mics in Hampshire in recent times, and we're going to tell a story song, which you can hope all sing along with. Whoops.
Let's see if I can.
There are some steps up that side.
Oh, right, yeah. That's the only exercise I've had today.
We're going to sing The Irish Rover by the Dubliners and the Pogues, and of course, most of you will probably know the words, so you can join us too.
Nice big print, yes.
One, two, three, four, one, two.
On the 4th of July, 1806, we set sail from the sweet port of Cork. We were sailing away with a cargo of bricks for the Grand City Hall in New York. 'Twas a wonderful craft she was rigged fore and aft, and how the wild wind drove her. She struck several blasts, she had 27 masts, and they called her the Irish Rover. We had 1 million bags of the best psycho rags and 2 million barrels of salt. We had 3 million sides of old blind horses' hides. We had 4 million barrels of gold. We had 5 million hawks and 6 million dogs, 7 million barrels of porter. We had 8 million bales of old nanny goat's tails in the hold of the Irish Rover. There was only Coots who played hard on his flutes when the ladies lined up for a sail. He was tooting with skill for each sparkling quadrille, though the dancers were fluttered and bent. With his smart, witty talk, he was cock of the walk, and he rolled the dames under and over. They knew and took a glance when he took up his stance that he sailed in the Irish Rover. There was Barney McGee from the banks of the Lee. There was Hogan from County Tyrone. There was Johnny McGurk, who was scarce if of work, and a man from Westmeath called Malone. Slugger O'Toole, who was drunk as a rule, and fighting Bill Tracy from Dover, and your man McMurray. 7 years when the measles broke out and the ship lost its way in the fog. And that whale of a crew was reduced down to two, just myself and the captain's old dog. Then the ship struck a rock, oh Lord, what a shock. The bulkhead was turned right over. She turned 9 times around, and the poor old dog was drowned.
Don't sound very sympathetic.
I'm the last of the Irish Rover. It was a wonderful crop. She was rigged for and loved. And how the wild wind drove her. She struck several blasts. She had 27 masts. And they called her the Irish Rover.
Ba-da-da-da, ba-da-da-da, ba-da-da-da.
first half about borrowing the songs from, interestingly, what Robin was saying when he was talking about Gulf Coast Highway, I got it from Andy and John as well. I mentioned that I got songs from the Sobers and Strums, and this is one that we started to sing, although it's better as a solo. It doesn't really work with ukuleles because it's a bit sort of bonkety bonk. It's called Perfect. It's by a group called Lightning Seeds from about the 1980s. It's not really a story song, I don't think. I don't entirely understand what it's about. Anyway. See the rivers filled with rain. I wish they could be blue again. Hazy petrol nights, crimson sun on traffic lights. A perfect day, a perfect night. Tell me all those perfect lies. Fly back in the garden till it's light. Streets get full up every night with people buzzing round the lights and waving at the taxis passing by. Now tomorrow's here today, and yesterday's today's just fade away. Watch the morning chase the night, rolling home, it's getting light. Feeling sleepy, full of wine, fall in bed just in time. The perfect stare, perfect eyes, that kiss you as they tell you lies, and wonder where you're going, where you've been. In towers high with time to fill, gardens on your windowsill, in between the pavements and sky. Now tomorrow's here today, and yesterday's today. Just fade away. Tell me why all the words will never come out right. Fumbling lines, I'm driving through the danger signs. A perfect day, a perfect night. Tell me all those perfect lies and lie back in the garden till it's light. Perfect silence, me and you. It's really me, I really do remember every moment magnified. Now tomorrow's here today, and yesterday's today's just fade away. The story, just in case people don't know, it's set on the locks of the St Lawrence Seaway, the channels which connect the Great Lakes between America and Canada. And this is a song. The whole thing sounds like it ought to be a duet, but it isn't. The whole thing is sung by a lockkeeper talking to a captain of a boat sailing to the South Seas. Every time this captain comes through, he tries to persuade the lockkeeper to go sailing to the South Seas with him. And the lockkeeper keeps saying, no, I want to stay with my wife. You say, well met again, lockkeeper. We're laden even deeper than the time. Oriental oils and tea brought down from Singapore. As we wait for my lock to cycle, I say my wife has just given me a son. A son, you say, is that all you have done? She wears bougainvillea blossoms.
pluck them from her hair and toss them in the tide. Sweep her in your arms and carry her inside. Her sighs catch on your shoulders, her lid eyes grow bold and wiser through her tears. And I say, how could you stand to leave her for a year? So come with me, you say, to where the Southern Cross rides high upon your shoulders. Come with me, you cry, each day you tend this lock, you're one day older, as your blood grows colder. But your anchor chains are fetter, and with it you are tethered to the foam. And I would not trade your life for 1 hour of sure, I'm stuck here on the seaway while you compensate for leeway through the trades. And you shoot the stars to see the miles you made. And you laugh at hearts you've riven, but which of these has given us more love or life? You, your tropic maids, or me, my wife. So come with me, you say, to where the Southern Cross rides high upon your shoulders. Come with me, you cry, each day you tend this walk, you're one day older, as your blood grows colder. But your anchor chains are fetter, and with it you are tethered to the foam. And I would not trade your life for 1 hour of home. Yes, your anchor chains are fettered, and with it you are tethered to the foam. And I would not trade your whole life for 1 hour of home.
South Sea trip sounds good to me.
Yeah.
This is a story song. In fact, it's more a story than a song, and it's sort of been experimental singing really, because it probably ought to be sung by a 14-year-old girl from Southern America. So you'll have to use your imagination to some extent. There was a film made of it. It's owed to Billy Joe by Bobby Gentry. There was a film made about it when Stephen Fry was on Desert Island Discs. He chose this as one of the most influential records that he'd heard. Now, you're not going to hear any virtuoso guitar on this one. Not that you've heard any virtuoso guitar from his singing anyway, but it's only got three chords and they don't change very often. So I think the way to treat this song is to think about it as if it's a story, but with a bit of a musical background to it. And I've changed one word slightly to make it relevant to a man singing or a boy singing. It was the 3rd of June, another sleepy, dusty Delta day. I was out chopping cotton and my brother was baling hay. At dinner time we stopped to walk back to the house to eat. And Mama hollered out the back door, you'll remember to wipe your feet. And then she said, I got some news this morning from Choctaw Ridge. Today Billy Joe McAllister jumped off the Tallahatchie Bridge. And Papa said to Mama, as he passed around the black eyed peas, well, Billy Joe never had a lick of sense past the biscuits, please. There's 5 more acres in the lower 40 I've got to plow.
said it was a shame about Billy Joe, anyhow. It seems that nothing ever comes to no good up on Jobtown Ridge. And now Billy Joe McAllister's jumped off the Tallahatchie Bridge. And brother recollected when he and Tom and Billy Joe put a frog down my back at the Carroll County Picture Show. And wasn't I talking with him after church last Sunday night? I'll have another piece of apple pie, you know, it don't seem right. I saw him at the sawmill yesterday up on Choctaw Ridge. And now you tell me Billy Joe's jumped off the Tallahatchie Bridge. And Mama said to me, child, what's happened to your appetite? I've been cooking all morning and you haven't touched a single bite. That nice young preacher, Brother Taylor, dropped by today. Said he'd be pleased to have dinner on Sunday. Oh, by the way, he said he saw a boy that looked a lot like you up on Choctaw Ridge. He and Billy Joe were throwing something off the Tallahatchie Bridge. A year has come and gone since we heard the news about Billy Joe. And brother married Becky Thompson, they bought a store in Tupelo. There was a virus going round, Papa caught it and he died last spring. Now, Mama doesn't seem to want to do much of anything. And me, I spend a lot of time picking flowers up on Choctaw Ridge and tossing into the muddy waters off the Tallahatchie
now. This is a poem, which is also in one of those books. Some of you may have heard it before. It came about because Linda and I used to spend a lot of holidays in Wales. We still do. And I noticed that when you drive across the Welsh border, the road signs change. The road sign for slow, for example, reads Arab slow when you go into Wales. And I wondered for a long time what an Arab was that would mean that you had to go slow to avoid it. And there's the same thing with the... are there any Welsh people in the audience? Well, no, good, that's very forward.
Just say.
And the same thing with the give way signs in Wales. They seem to have Ildiwch written on them for some reason. And I looked into it, and it seems that these are the names of animals that can be found in the area, and they helpfully put them on the road sign. So I wrote this poem called The Arab and the Ildiwch. In the wilds of Western Wales, mythic creatures still abound, whose name for information on the road signs can be found. The Arab is a vocal beast. Hills echo with his call. He looks quite like a womble, though he's all of 12 feet tall. To visitors, his risk is small. Say boo, and he will go. But never will he rush himself. Thus signs warn, Arab, slow. The Ildiwch is dangerous, these teeth and spines and claws. He'll not care for your safety, nor for any human laws. It's very best to follow the advice the road signs say. If you chance upon an Ildiwch, don't cross his path, give way. Treeth are aquatic mammals with green fur and huge blue feet. They live in social colonies where many thousands meet. As unprotected species, habitats are out of reach. A conservation sanctuary is often marked treat beach. Coloeba cahoides are rodents who excavate burrows in the ground, but despite fluorescent ears and tails, they're very rarely found. So if this timid animal might just be there to see, it's announced on public footpath signs in the vicinity. Strange beasties roam this ancient land. Rabbit, Araf Ochnawa, Dorset, Gorathino Vallis, and very many more. You too can see this fauna. Go searching rarely fails. Just watch out for the signposts as you journey into Wales. That's many Welsh people around offended. Now it's time to move on to offending Southern American fundamentalist Christians. Are there any Southern American fundamentalist Christians in the room?
I'm going to read
the story of this. You all know it. It's called Will Hunting Down by Jez Lowe. But I'll read before I play it. This is quicker and easier, the way it's phrased. To read how this song came about. It's to do with the Darwin Song Project, which was an album released on the 7th of September 2009. It features folk artists from the UK and North America who were tasked with the creation of a new song that had a resonance and relevance to Charles Darwin. On the 13th of March 2009, eight artists gathered together at Henley Farmhouse in rural Shropshire for a week-long songwriting retreat to create new works that related to Darwin, who was born in Shrewsbury in 1809. Now, most of the people involved with the Darwin Project wrote songs about ships on the sea, as you might kind of expect. But Jez Lowe wrote this one, which I think he has also sung in Southern America and lived to tell the tale. Across this noble country, this fair land of the free, I'm searching for a man who's made a monkey out of me. And God is riding with me, and half the town is too. His name is Charlie Darwin, and he must not speak with you. We'll hunt him down, we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down.
And every word he ever said will burn into the ground. We'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down.
Charles Robert Darwin, you're not welcome in this town. Well, at first we thought him crazy, so we just let him be, playing with worms and beetles and little critters from the sea. Then he started spreading rumors that you scarcely would believe, that my ancestors were chimpanzees, not Adam and Eve. We'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down.
And every word he ever said will burn into the ground. We'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down.
Charles Robert Darwin, you're not welcome in this town. Now it's hard to speak about him without sinking to abuse. They say that he's an Englishman, but still that's no excuse. He's robbed our schools and churches of the truth the Bible tells. So we'll have to stop his godless ways and burn his words to hell. We'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down.
Every word he ever said will burn into the ground. We'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down.
Charles Robert Darwin, you're not welcome in this town. Now we're holy and we're righteous, and we know it to be true, that it was on a Saturday morning that God made me and you. He made us smart and clever, he even gave us tools, like guns and bows and rifles, cause he's a Republican too. We'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down.
And every word he ever said will burn into the ground. We'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down.
Charles Robert Darwin, you're not welcome in this town. We'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down.
And every word he ever said will burn into the ground. We'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down,
we'll hunt him down.
Charles Robert Darwin,